In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. Today's Mass is with the special intention of Vincent Martorella, and also remember a special way the brother of our lector, Tom Rosansky, Brian, who suffered a stroke recently. As we come today's Eucharist, we recognize in the reading today, especially in the Old Testament reading, that Elijah the prophet is one with great power. He brings God's word to the people who had forgotten him. In our world today, we need to be the new prophets. We have to bring God's word to those who have forgotten God's presence. Sometimes we're ashamed to bring our faith out to others. Let us ask the Lord that strength and forgiveness if we have not done so. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Just a correction on the intention of the Mass. It is offered for Robert Salerno, deceased. Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call upon you in our need may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Ahab sent to all the children of Israel and had the prophets assemble on Mount Carmel. Elijah appealed to all the people and said, "How long will you straddle the issue? If the Lord is God, follow him. If Baal, follow him." The people, however, did not answer him. So Elijah said to the people, "I am the only surviving prophet of the Lord, and there are 450 prophets of Baal. Give us two young bulls. Let them choose one, cut it into pieces, and place it on the wood, but start no fire. I shall prepare the other and place it on the wood, but start no fire. You shall call on your gods, and I will call on the Lord. The God who answers with fire is God." All the people answered, "Agreed." Elijah then said to the prophets of Baal, "Choose one young bull and prepare it first, for there are more of you. Call upon your gods, but do not start the fire." Taking the young bull that was turned over to them, they prepared it and called on Baal from morning till noon, saying, "Answer us, Baal." But there was no sound and no one answering. And they hopped about the altar they had prepared. When it was noon, Elijah taunted them, "Call louder, for he is a god and may be meditating, or may have retired, or may be on a journey. Perhaps he is asleep and must be awakened." They called out louder and slashed themselves with swords and spears, as was their custom, till blood gushed over them. Noon passed, and they remained in a prophetic state until the time for offering sacrifice. But there was not a sound. No one answered, and no one was listening. Then Elijah said to all the people, "Come here to me." When the people had done so, he repaired the altar of the Lord that had been destroyed. He took 12 stones for the number of tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the Lord had said, "Your name shall be Israel." He built an altar in honor of the Lord with the stones and made a trench around the altar large enough for 2 measures of grain. When he had arranged the wood, he cut up the young bull and laid it on the wood. "Fill 4 jars with water," he said, "and pour it over the burnt offering and over the wood." "Do it again," he said, and they did it again. "Do it a third time," he said, and they did it a third time. The water flowed around the altar, and the trench was filled with the water. At the time for offering sacrifice, the prophet Elijah came forward and said, "Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, and that I am your servant, and have done all these things by your command. Answer me, Lord. Answer me, that this people may know that you, Lord, are God, and that you have brought them back to their senses." The Lord's fire came down and consumed the burnt offering, wood, stones, and dust, and it lapped up the water in the trench. Seeing this, all the people fell prostrate and said, "The Lord is God. The Lord is God." The word of the Lord. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord are you. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. They multiply their sorrows who court other gods. Blood libations to them I will not pour out, nor will I take their names upon my lips. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. O Lord, my allotted portion and cup, you it is who hold fast my lot. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Keep me safe, O Lord, you are my hope. You will show me the path to life, fullness of joys in your presence, the delights at your right hand forever. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. Amen, I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter or the smallest part of a letter will pass from the law, until all things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do so will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called greatest in the kingdom of heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. The prophet Elijah is one of my most famous prophets for a couple of reasons. First, one of my grandfathers, born in Italy, came from a town called Santa Lia, which is Holy Elias. But also because Elias is the prophet of Mount Carmel. My own special devotion to Our Lady of Mount Carmel comes because Elijah took refuge after we see the scene today that he was able to dispel the prophets of Baal. In the reading tomorrow, we'll see that he put to the sword those 400 prophets, not something we would do in the New Testament. But then he took refuge because the queen was after him to kill him, for he had destroyed the temple to the god Baal. And at that time on Mount Carmel, he contemplated the meaning of life and asked God to take his life. But rather, God came to him and said he must continue to live. Sometimes in our own life, probably sometimes midway, we wonder, what's life about? Where's life going? Contemplation is when we put ourselves before God, not so much with many words, but listening to God's voice that speaks to us. Elijah, remember, was one of the prophets who was with Jesus at the Transfiguration. It was Moses and Elijah. Elijah brings the prophetic mission of the church to our understanding today. Yes, we hear in the gospel today about the law, and Moses was the lawgiver. Keep the law. But there is that prophetic part of our understanding of our life as Christians that we must speak on behalf of God, because that's what prophets do. They're not necessarily foretellers of the future, but rather they speak for God in the midst of the world, bringing God's message to other people. We do that by our simple lives, by our lives lived for Christ, our lives sometimes with the contemplation and prayer that we bring to make our lives full of meaning. As we return today to the altar, we ask the Lord to give us that spirit of Elijah, a spirit of fierceness, of defending the understanding of God in the world, a world then that did not accept God, the same world we live in today, but at the same time that we become speakers for God, prophets, by the way we live and the way we witness to Him. Prayers and petitions before our Heavenly Father with great confidence that what we ask in the name of Jesus will be granted us. So we pray for Holy Father Pope Francis that he has continued health and strength to continue leading the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the bishops of the church, its priests, deacons, all who minister in Christ's name, our religious brothers and sisters, all who are witnesses in the world to the presence of God, that they may never waver in their ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those commended to our prayers, those the sick especially, the victims of violence that we have so many today, that they may find strength in their faith. We pray to the Lord. We pray for an increase of vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that many young people will give their lives for Christ and His church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear.
We pray for our deceased relatives and friends, all those close to us, that they who enjoy with the presence of God, we may someday be united with them in the communion of saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear.
We mention our own petitions in the silence of our hearts. Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the good things you've given us. We ask in your mercy to answer also these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Ave Maria, gratia plena. Tecum,
my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer may be acceptable as an oblation to you, and lead us to grow in charity through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts.
And with the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Dominus Deus.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly give you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing this sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and the blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant, Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, me, your unworthy servant, the order of bishops and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, and your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. For there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, you shouldn't enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be yours.
Draw us in.
Let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil, and lead us to what is right through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The prayer to St. Michael the Archangel. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Litany of Saint Joseph. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy. Have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
protector of Christ.
Pray for us.
Head of the Holy Family.
Pray for us.
Joseph, most just.
Pray for us.
Joseph, most chaste.
Pray for us.
Joseph, most prudent.
Pray for us.
Joseph, most strong.
Pray for us.
Joseph, most obedient.
Pray for us.
Joseph, most faithful.
Pray for us.
Mirror of patience.
Pray for us.
Lover of poverty.
Pray for us.
Model of artisans.
Pray for us.
Glory of home life.
Pray for us.
Guardian of virgins.
Pray for us.
O God, who in your loving providence chose blessed Joseph to be the spouse of your most holy mother, grant us the favor of having him for our intercessor in heaven, whom on earth we venerate as our protector. You who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. An act of consecration to Saint Joseph. By St. Alphonsus Liguori. O Holy Patriarch, I rejoice with you at the exalted dignity by which you were deemed worthy to act as Father to Jesus, to give him orders and to be obeyed by him whom heaven and earth obey. O great Saint, as you were served by God, I too wish to be taken into your service. I choose you, after Mary, to be my chief advocate and protector. I promise to honor you every day by some special act of devotion and by placing myself under your daily protection. By that sweet company which Jesus and Mary gave you in your lifetime, protect me all through life so that I may never separate myself from my God by losing his grace. My dear Saint Joseph, pray to Jesus for me. Certainly, he can never refuse you anything, as he obeyed all your orders while on earth. Tell him to detach me from all creatures and from myself, to inflame me with his holy love, and then to do with me what he pleases. By that assistance which Jesus and Mary gave you at death, I beg of you to protect me in a special way at the hour of my death, so that, dying assisted by you in the company of Jesus and Mary, I may go to thank you in paradise and in your company to praise my God for all eternity. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.